What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Say hi, Ellie. We have Ash. In today's video, I want to talk to you guys about the truth about Miami. But before I do that, let's go ahead and just get on to the day. Let's start off the morning by going to the gym.
Welcome Fearless. To the channel.
So this is my current physique right now. If everything goes right, I should be shredded in a matter of 12 weeks. I've done it before. It's not really hard for me to do. Well, it's hard to do, but mentally wise, I've already done it, so it's easy for me to follow through. Shout out ASRB for the sick pants. If you know, I'm always wearing ASRB for the pants. This shirt is actually one of my shirts. I made it a long time ago. Failed business of mine. Never brought it back to life because it's failed, you know? You know, a lot of things that entrepreneurs do is they hold on to an idea because they love it so much, and then they just keep on failing at it. If you're doing something and you're not doing good at it for like 3 years, maybe do something new, or maybe you really know it's gonna work out, then I don't know, stay. But I like profits and I like making money quick. Well, not quick, but more so, I like to see results quickly, or at least a good amount of results pretty quickly for order me to stay motivated. Whenever I don't see results right away, I start to get unmotivated. I don't want to do as much. So try to stick with things that make a lot of money right away, like extra car rentals. Hold on. Anyway, so like I said, I just woke up, so we're gonna go ahead and brush our teeth. Actually, I'm probably gonna wash my face first, or brush my teeth first. I don't know. I'm gonna go with brushing my teeth. Gotta keep teeth white, you know? All right, now that I brushed my teeth, I'm gonna go ahead and shave. I'm gonna actually try to do this trend. I need to stop looking over there and look over here. I'm gonna try to do this transition I've never done before. Let's see if it works. There we go, we're all fresh and shaved. Now, there's one key I'm about to give you guys. My girlfriend bought this for me, and it's been a lifesaver. It's this thing right here. So you go ahead and look up here, it's my hairline. So I get a haircut about once a week, sometimes a little longer than a week because I get busy, and sometimes I'm just on point and I do it every like 5 days or so. But this keeps my hairline right here extremely fresh. Let me go ahead and show you right now. So all the little baby hairs that come in, I just go ahead and get rid of them, making it seem that I just got a haircut. Don't go too crazy. Definitely be very careful how high you go up. For me, I like more of a natural look, so I take off most of them. But if you don't know your line, just maybe ask your barber before doing it. But look, see, you see how this side is all clean and this one still has all the hair. So basically, that's what we're gonna go ahead and do. And then once it's all cleaned up, you can go, this basically gives you like an extra 3 days to your haircut. Just keeps it fresh, keeps it nice and looking, and you can go on about your day. All right, so now we're ready to go walk the dogs and then go to the gym. Or I might just go to the gym and have my boy walk the dog. We don't know yet. Let's see what happens. Ooh, look at all that extra car rental academy money. Just kidding, that's extra car rental money. If you want to make money like that, you know what you have to do. But let's go ahead and grab the keys. Oh, this thing is so big. Now, listen, every morning, without a doubt, I have to wake Tommy up. Every time, and it's always hilarious. So let's go ahead and do that now. And there's so many much. Oh, also, shout out Tommy for finally getting me the PS5. I've been trying to get it for a long time and wasn't able to, but he clutched it and gave me an early birthday gift. So in return, we're gonna go fuck with him. What are you doing? Wake the hell up, man. Hey, wake the hell up, man. Wake the hell up, dude. What is this? Is that a freaking nipple? You woke up like this? So what's up to the vlog, man? We're back vlogging.
What's up, vlog?
What's up, man? Let's go to the gym. Okay. That is a beautiful view. Sprinkle views and water views, both sides. There you go. But anyways, today's video, we're gonna be addressing a lot of shit, honestly. Well, not addressing a lot of shit, but filling you guys in into a lot of shit about Miami, okay? So, like I said earlier this morning, there's a lot of stuff in Miami that people don't tell you until you move in. And if you're an entrepreneur or you make money or some kind of sort, then you know, you might wanna know these things before coming here, because I had to find out on my own. Nobody told me any of this. First thing I found out is, in Miami, nobody ever sleeps. Oh my God, I just realized I don't even have the mic on. Give me 1 second. There we go. I'm pretty sure the mic is on. I connected it, I turned it on, so hopefully it's on. But the first thing about Miami that they don't tell you, actually they do tell you. They tell you it's always open. It's an amazing time. You're gonna have to have a lot of fun, but that's also a problem. It's always open. Miami never sleeps. I'm saying there's everything, it's always open. I just repeated myself multiple times. But basically, people here party 24/7. And if you are somebody in the car rental business or any kind of business where you know a lot of people like myself, it turns out that, you know, let's say friend A is going out at 9 p.m. and is hitting me up, yo, Ethan, let's hang out, blah, blah, blah. And if I say no, then, you know, I gotta hear it later on, bro, you never hang out with me, this and that. Then I have another friend going out at 12 p.m., then another friend going out at 2 a.m., and then that crazy friend is always down to go out more at 4 a.m. all the way into forever. And if you don't want to party, it's already 7 a.m. and you're about to go home, there's always that one friend that wants to go to the casino, and now you're gambling all your money away. So Miami's non-stop party, and if you don't have any control over yourself, you will not be productive. You just party all the time. Another thing is, Miami is a highly visited place for vacation or for a quick weekend. So again, same thing. I have my own sort of car rental business in LA. I'm originally from New York. I have friends in Orlando. I really have friends all over the world. So it feels like every weekend a new friend is coming into town and wants to hang out. And if I don't hang out with them, oh, Ethan, I was in town, I was in your city, and you didn't come spend time with me. You didn't take out time to hang out with your boy. And then they feel some type of way. So every weekend, you know, Josh's coming this weekend, next weekend, Tom's coming that weekend, the next weekend, Brady's coming this weekend. I don't know why I say all super white people's name, but it just seems like every weekend people are partying. And they come here and they have a blast. They enjoy their weekend. Well, for me, it's really just like a regular weekend. Today's video is the truth about Miami.
Truth about Miami.
The truth about me. Actually, you should throw in some points. So I already spoke about number one.
Yeah.
Always open, and there's always somebody in town to a party or a friend that wants to hang out. And literally, I know you guys are saying, just say no, stay home. But then you're.
Yeah.
Then like, yo, you don't hang out with me. You're like, bro, people really get really butthurt just because you don't go out with them. Like, whatever. Another reason is the weather. It's getting extremely freaking hot, and I get super freaking dark. So I play hide and seek with the sun. This is something that everybody knows. I do not like the beach. I don't like doing those kind of things. And when it's really hot and humid, I just hate it. I feel like I can't breathe. So that's another reason it's getting really, 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 really hot. Yeah, just hot. What are we working on today? Oh, we're doing triceps, because we didn't do tricep last week. We were supposed to go Saturday or Sunday, and we didn't go. So we're gonna go work out triceps and do, oh, I was supposed to bring the jump rope, but I forgot.
We've actually been pretty consistent with the gym also, so yeah. Going 5 days a week.
So a lot of people think that I'm short, because I'm always sitting next to him and he's Asian, but he's actually 6'3" and I'm 6 feet. So I'm not short. He's just very tall.
Yeah.
Like a giraffe. If you do nicknames, you'd be giraffe instead of Chino.
Chinese giraffe. But I'm not even Chinese. Chino giraffe.
Chino
giraffe. Yeah. So another thing about Miami, as you can see, only the Huracan is in, and that's because I am not renting out the Huracan anymore. The Huracan is my personal car now. I don't want to rent it. I don't want to take a damage. But every other car, if you know my cars in Miami, is rented. You can go, it's fine. Every other car in Miami is rented, which means the volume of rentals that I do is absolutely insane. Cars just go out consistently because there's so much people. But the price of rental is so low, it f***s in my head. I can't deal with it. For example, this car over here in Miami, they rent for anywhere between $700 to $1,300 if the client is not really aware. So, $700 for a Huracan? I just can't do it. I'd rather keep it to myself. Well, in New York, the prices for a Huracan is starts at $1,500 all the way up to $2,000. And in LA, it starts at $1,100 all the way up to $1,600. So the price range is lower, the volume is higher, which gives you more wear and tear and more miles. So I just don't really like that much. Jesus Christ, look at that. I need gas ASAP. I mean. Yo, I thought I was recording just now. I wasn't even recording, but look at this beautiful F8. I wouldn't buy F8 anytime soon because they're way too high up in price. It's gonna go down in value very, very soon. So I wouldn't personally buy one, but that F8 outside is beautiful. We just made it to the gym. Look at what mad at me. One thing though, if you do move to Miami, come to Anatomy. All the baddies come here. What's going on, guys? It is 12:57 and 58 at night. And I'm about to get ready to go to sleep, but I was supposed to finish this video. I was supposed to talk to you throughout the day about all the reasons, well, about the truth about Miami, but I got distracted. People come up to me and start talking, I get distracted working, and then I end up not finishing the video. This is actually the seventh video I tried to make that midway through the video, I'll get distracted doing something else and I won't finish it, and then I'll just trash it. This video, however, is more about information and giving you guys the truth about Miami, so I am gonna post it, and then I'm gonna try my best to just stick consistently, because I feel like YouTube is an amazing way for me to give free value to a lot of people that can't afford things like my program, Start Car Rental Academy, which I don't like to plug that much over here, just because that's for people that wanna actually make money, not for people that I gotta convince to wanna make money. It's a lot easier to teach somebody that has that mindset and ambition and desire to be successful than somebody doesn't want to. So I don't like to sell, I like to teach people that actually want to get into it. But to get to the bottom of this video, I'm gonna go ahead and finish it now. I said, number one, still in Miami, people don't know, everything is always open, which means it's consistent partying, non-stop partying. Number two, I said, there's always somebody in town. There's always somebody new in town that's gonna come out. Hey, what's going on? I'm in town, let's go hang out. And if you say no, you just look like a complete head. You don't look a good friend. It's a bad look on you or in general, or you're gonna hurt somebody's feeling. Actually, while we sat there in the elevator at the gym, somebody went up to Tommy and said to him, yo, bro, I invited him to my table at 11 of the night. He didn't show up. I invited him to my house 25 times, he doesn't show up. Does he feel some type of way about me? And I don't, I just get invited so much by everybody that I don't have a chance to stay home. Me, I feel like it's very hard to stay productive in Miami. The other major thing about Miami is that it's so hard to be special. I mean, having a Lamborghini and being in LA, like just even in LA, even every city I've been in, if you have a Lambo, that's a huge accomplishment. You get treated so much better everywhere you go just because you have that. You feel so special. It's just completely separated from the rest of the world that just lives a little bit regular. Here in Miami, oh my God, it's impossible to feel that way. Everybody in Miami has a Lambo, Ferrari, a McLaren, whatever it may be, all the latest designer, the everything. Because you have people who actually own it, and you have people that come in with $20,000-$30,000, rent that lifestyle for the weekend, and it's all you consistently see every single day. Miami's not regular whatsoever. To pop out, it's completely rare. You need to have a Bugatti nowadays in Miami to actually be like, okay, this guy's doing something good, or this girl's doing something really good. Miami is just overall just a lot of everything in your face and always happening, which for me, it just seems to be very, very draining. It seems like everybody over here just wants to keep up with the latest trends and upgrade their life rather than upgrade their business, which puts me in a weird mindset. I'm the type of person that I like to be around people that are working consistently every single day and upgrading their business, not their lifestyle, because I feed off that and I get competitive, and then I just become my best self because I want to put in my all into things that I do, and having those kind of people around just make me work better, you know? I'm definitely somebody that my surroundings affect how I feel. When I'm alone, I tend to not work that much because, I don't know, it's just, I need the surroundings to consistently remind me, hey, don't mess up. Get to work, get to work, get to work, get to work. And over here in Miami, it's more like, hey, let's party, let's party, let's party, let's party. So I was going out so much at the beginning, I barely got any work done. When I finally figured that out, I was spending like 10 to 20,000 bucks every club here. Because every club here is not just a club, it's also a strip club. There's no such thing as just a club in Miami. Every club will have strippers. And the minimum will be 5 to 10K every single night, everywhere you go. So once I stopped wanting to go to the strip clubs and the clubs, I didn't know what to do. I didn't want to spend money on liquor anymore. I didn't want to spend money on girls. So I started going to the casino. And the first 17 days, oh my God, I was winning, making 1,500 to 2,000 bucks every single day. After those 17, 20 days, I started losing every single time. I think last week alone, I lost like over 10 grand just by going and losing 1,200, 2,000, 1,500, 2,000, 1,500. Just stupidly trying to make my money back. So completely bad habit that Miami has made for me. So overall, I just think Miami is not a good place for me and my headspace to just be the best version of myself. I'm not motivated to do better. It just seems like, I don't know. I haven't met anybody or I haven't ran across something that's making me like wanna do more, wanna work harder, wanna just do better. Instead, it's more so, hey bro, what's going on this weekend? We're gonna go this weekend, what are we gonna do? Did you buy the new Celine? Did you buy this? And it's just not the mindset that I'm trying to have. And like I've said it before multiple times, if you add 10 people, you'll be the 11th. If you add their income, you'll have, like by, if you add 10 people's income you hang out with and divide it by 10, that'll be somewhere around your income. It's just kind of how life is. I need to be around the right energy, around the right mindset so that I can be my best self. And Miami is just not allowing me to do that. With that being said, we are gonna go ahead and relocate from Miami. I'm not gonna say where yet. Actually, I'm not even sure it's gonna happen tomorrow. Actually, today already. In 3 hours, we're gonna be flying to this new location. I just booked the hotel and the flights for everybody. And I hope this is a good decision because I wanna make you more YouTube videos to get free content for you guys. I wanna work more and I wanna hit my goals this year. I'm a little late on them, to be honest. So I think a new place and a new environment will help me do that. So with that being said, guys, thank you for being so patient with me. I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys what I've been packing. That way you guys know. Actually, if I tell you what I'm packing, you might know where we're going, but it's already 1:05. So we should be leaving. We leave in 3 hours. No, 4 hours.
Thomas playing 2K.
Yeah. Look at that. I got him that for his birthday.
I already told him you got me that this morning.
P5.
Yeah, I already told him that. Tommy got me an early birthday present and bought me the PlayStation 5. My girlfriend bought me Spider-Man and my friend Buff bought, actually, I guess nothing yet because you bought 2K as well and you bought the other controller. Yeah. Tommy's a great friend. Great, great, great friend. Did you pack already?
man.
What are you gonna pack? Well, I haven't told them where we're going, so don't say anything.
That's gonna say it.
But here, we have, oh, look at Ash.
Ash, buddy, you excited? You excited when we be leaving? What's going on, Cole?
So here we got the bags. These are, I'm gonna wear tomorrow. You guys know me, you gotta have some cash on deck where we go. I'm gonna be having this watch only. This bracelet and this bracelet that my mom gave me for Christmas. I basically wear it every single time. This is one of my first watches that I've loved. So this is my boy's Blake new brand, Hype Hats. You guys gotta check it out. It's actually pretty fire. Gonna be wearing that Balenciaga hoodie, Stone Island pants, and a Mary shirt right here. I actually honestly don't think I'm gonna be needing this backpack because I'm only gonna go for 2 days to check out some units that are available. So I don't think I'm gonna be needing that. I think with this it'll be enough. Here we have my Louis Vuitton travel cologne. Honestly, this is probably the best cologne I've ever smelled. It smells like the store, so it smells like you just went shopping. So if you want to get some gold diggers, then you know what to get. And then toiletry bag, all this stuff is going to go in here. Put it in there after I shave, brush my teeth and stuff this morning. I'll put it in here and then we'll be good to go, I think. So yeah, it's probably gonna wrap up this video. We'll go ahead and see you guys in 4 hours.
Spreading the news.